Good morning, good afternoon, or good evening, depending on where you're joining our live broadcast from today. My name is Tony Beeston, and I will be hosting your event. Briefly, some housekeeping. We are on a public webinar, so your phone lines will remain on mute. Please use the questions section in Bright Talk to raise any questions you have from today's presentation. Jan will go through these at the end. This webinar is being recorded and will be available to you through the same link you joined with today. So if you want to review over the coming week or share with others, you can. Now, with that done, I'd like to introduce you to Jan Gurnjan, our speaker for today. He's a veteran of the IT industry who has specialized in automation for many years. His focus on SAP means he is the perfect person to take us through how automation can improve performance and generate new levels of agility in our organizations. So without further ado, Jan, the floor is yours.
Thank you, Tony. Hello, everybody. This is Jan Gurnjan speaking. I am in charge of SAP Automation Solutions at CA Technology, as Tony said just before. So welcome to this webinar, and thank you for your participation. Today's webinar is about SAP, and more precisely, it is about agility. We will discuss the importance of automation. We know that business demands are increasing and putting some pressure on SAP teams. I assume you have already been confronted to the difficulty of properly automating SAP. That's why in this webinar, we will address three major automation use cases you should definitely think about to increase your SAP agility. At CA Technology, we believe that automation can help to improve SAP automation operations and allow new levels of business agility. A bit of details on today's agenda. I will be covering the digital transformation and the postmodern ERP, the end-to-end process automation for SAP, also how to better integrate SAP into DevOps processes, and to finish, how to automate incident remediation for SAP. Okay, so I propose to start right now. And it was, of course, difficult to start without mentioning digital transformation. You know, we discuss a lot with our customers, and it makes clear that nearly every company is looking for a way to better drive their digital transformation. So I'm sure you perfectly know about the digital transformation story. It's all about business pressure, pressure that drives technological and organizational changes. In fact, why are you transforming? Simply because you need to innovate fast in order to stay in the game and avoid to be overtaken by the competition. So everybody knows companies that have been disrupting their markets, Uber, Airbnb, Amazon. Those guys have been starting up the digital economy, and what they did it by delivering a totally innovative customer experience. Of course, you absolutely know that Uber is just about calling a taxi, Amazon is just about selling goods, but the way they do has just been disrupting. So today, no company is really safe from disruption. Every business vertical is exposed, media, telco, finance, just every vertical. Then companies are looking for ways to redefine how they interact with their customers. Of course, it has a big impact on IT organizations, mostly in the way they deliver services to the external world. In fact, they need to let customers to interact more directly with the corporate IT. Okay, then what are the consequences for the ERPs like SAP? So first, let's remind a bit of history. The ERP, as we know today, is a result of an evolution since the beginning of the 80s. You had already several transformations, and today's digital transformation is just the latest step of this evolution. ERP was born in the beginning of the 90s, and the ERP acronym was created by Gartner, the analyst company. Modern ERP concept was presented as a revolution, a kind of new breed of integrated software suite. It included the former MRP capabilities, specifically designed to manage manufacturing and production. And on top of that, it was integrating many other capabilities in a single suite, like financials, human resources, or CRM. So maybe this is because of this massive level of integration that ERPs started to have a bad reputation. The price tag and the relative inflexibility of the ERP systems have been driving spectacular implementation failures. So I'm sure you already heard about that in the press. So this is a pain that needs to be addressed for surviving the latest transformation, the actual so-called digital transformation. This is why today many organizations have been changing their strategy. They are now trying to identify distinct strategies for each category of applications. It is an alternative to the monolithic strategy of the traditional ERP implementation. So what is exactly the postmodern ERP? The postmodern ERP is a relatively new concept. Once again, it has been defined by Gartner. It was defined in 2015. And you can see that the original definition by Gartner is a bit complicated. The way I like to explain the postmodern ERP is a kind of deconstruction. The ERP suite is deconstructed into a loose set of connected business functions. And of course, the masterpiece technology behind the postmodern ERP is the cloud. I think postmodern ERP is really a consequence of the tectonic shift that is occurring into the IT operations. IT operations are shifting. They are shifting from being a service provider to become a service broker. From just keeping the lights on, they are expected to become a true business partner for innovation and for growth. So don't get me wrong, I'm not saying that we are going back to a best of breed situation. We are not back to the 80s. With postmodern ERP, there is still a core ERP. It can be on-prem or it can be in the cloud, but the core is extended with some external specialist solutions. For example, the core can cover procurement, financials, and order management, and some external solutions can be implemented for the CRM and human resources. By the way, it can explain part of the success of companies like Salesforce or maybe Workday. In fact, if you try to do an analogy for the postmodern ERP, it is like you keeping your old car. You never change it, but you still run maintenance and you replace the old parts. You can also modernize it and make it more fancy by adding new options. Now the postmodern ERP does not come without a price to pay. And that price is the increased complexity. The postmodern ERP means managing processes that span other multiple technologies, on-prem, also in the cloud. It also means an increased pace of change that requires better levels of agility. So now let's have a look to the main challenges you might be confronted turning SAP into a postmodern ERP. So it might be your next challenge with SAP. On one side, running a hybrid SAP environment with components on-prem and components in the cloud. And on the other side, connecting SAP with third-party services that most of the time are software as a service applications. I think you can easily see there is a big integration challenge. The more you have third-party tools, the more it takes efforts to connect them to your core SAP. But it's not the only difficulty. The postmodern ERP initiatives are introducing three types of challenges that can impact your IT agility. The first one is about managing business processes end-to-end. This was not a challenge with standard ERPs because all the functions were centralized and integrated. In fact, centralization was the reason for being of these ERP suites. Postmodern ERP now introduces non-SAP and cloud components into your business processes. And you still need to be in control of the whole process execution. The second challenge is that you have to manage SAP applications and new digital applications into the same development and testing processes. That's why you need to ensure that your SAP processes are agile enough to support the pace of change that is induced by those new digital applications. When you are not agile enough with SAP, you slow down the agile development teams that are working on the digital application side. And I'm pretty sure that you know what is the worst agility roadblock with SAP. In fact, it is creating copies of SAP production systems for non-production matters like development, integration, testing, or training. The third challenge is in fact a consequence of the first one. How do you ensure a good user or a good customer experience when your processes are getting really, really complex? How can you stay really proactive when service levels rely on multiple technologies and multiple teams? So at CA Technologies, we have an answer to these three challenges. And the answer is simple, it is automation. Of course, many of you are going to tell me, hey, you know, I have a lot of automation yet. The problem is that companies have actually adopted a series of automation tools, but it was mainly to reduce expenses. In fact, it was to reduce the number of employees into the IT organization. Of course, there is a limit to the cost reduction. You cannot expect to continue to cut costs indefinitely. Today, automation benefits have to be redirected from the bottom line to the top line, meaning automation needs to enable faster innovation and better customer experience. And modern automation is the answer to growing complexity and growing business demands. So I propose to see how CA technology can help you to address the challenges of modern automation. The first use case is end-to-end automation. This is exactly what we discussed before. You need visibility, you need control on processes that run across multiple technologies. However, many companies still rely on disconnected automation. You have operating systems schedulers like Chrome on Linux or WTS on Windows. You might have ERP schedulers like Concurrent Manager on Oracle. You can have database schedulers like Microsoft SQL Agent. And it makes a lot of silos, a lot of disconnected automation. That's why today many companies are considering postmodern ERP, and they are facing agility issues because of that. If you think about it, every time you are adding new technologies, your production becomes more complex. You start to have issues to manage interdependencies. And if you're going hybrid, it doesn't help because you have services you control directly and some others that are managed externally. So what's happening in that situation? You have limited visibility. You don't know exactly what tasks are running and when execution is fully done. You experience process failures because of manual coordination between all the technologies. And you are getting slow for responding to business demands. The change becomes very difficult for you. In fact, Without proper orchestration, the big risk is to severely impact your agility and your speed of execution. And of course, that risk is directly proportional to the volume of manual operations you have in place. That said, what should you do? At CA Technologies, we believe that the best approach to automation should be holistic. We have designed our automation solution as a unique platform that enables to automate across multiple technologies. This is the Automic platform. Automic enables a perfect coordination in executing all the tasks that support your business processes. And it just works with many technologies, ERP systems, CRM, ETL tools, and many others. The result is that you can see all the tasks in one place, documented, understandable, and maintainable. Your business processes can run faster with less errors. So you can easily reach the speed and the agility that are required when implementing a postmodern ERP. Now let's have a look to a customer example. Singapore Power is an electricity and gas distribution company in Singapore. They have chosen SAP as their strategic ERP, and they were confronted to the classical postmodern ERP challenge. Their business processes had to extend beyond the SAP limits to include other core business activities. Then manual coordination between systems and also data transfers started to create problems. Many errors that needed to restart the processes, synchronization issues that generated data inconsistencies. It became really critical for an industry that was running with very strong regulations. With Automic, Singapore Power has simplified operations across SAP and non-SAP systems. They have improved reliability with less errors and global visibility on process execution. And they are now much more comfortable to make changes in the business processes design. So greater agility has enabled more innovation for Singapore Power. So on your side, now just a few figures about what you can expect reviewing your automation strategies. What you can see on the slide is extracted from a benchmark we created with analysts and customers. Holistic automation using a platform like Automic will help you to extend your cost savings. You can go beyond the limits of siloed automation and continue to reduce operational costs. But as we made clear before, this is not only about the bottom line. End-to-end automation improves agility and speed of execution. And we can see on the slide, it has also a visible impact on the top line. Okay, so now let's move to another use case where automation has even a more direct impact on innovation. I assume you know that doing an SAP system copy is not only complex, but it is also time-consuming. And with current trends like Agile, DevOps, Continuous Delivery, you need to increase the pace of your copies. This is a direct consequence of the digital transformation. You get more pressure from the business to get new features as quickly as possible. But of course, developing faster doesn't mean reducing the volume of testing. You are still accountable for the quality of your applications and your services. So what's happening? In fact, the development is pushing more changes to the QA. The QA is pushing more releases to the pre-production. All this means you need more non-production environment available for development, for testing, and for training activities. And this is true, of course, for the digital applications, but also for the SAP applications. Now, what is the big deal about SAP system copies? Let's have a look to the traditional ways of doing copies. I'm sure you have been faced already to some issues for provisioning test environments or training systems. Globally, system copies take too much time and they require too much manual operations. On top of that, creating copies can generate potential production time on the target systems, meaning that developers, testers, or trainees cannot work. In fact, all those guys are losing their time. They're just waiting for the target systems to be up and running. Then there is one question. Why is it so difficult to create SAP system copies and also to keep them up to date? Because not only you need to create copies, but you also need to keep them fresh and consistent. And the answer is, it is difficult because of hundreds of manual steps you need to run on the source and also on the target systems. And also because you need to involve multiple teams, like the basis team, the DBA team, or the storage team. Most of the time, you run into many coordination issues between the teams just because you cannot get the right guy available at the right time. The result is that it takes days or sometimes weeks to provision a new copy of an SAP landscape. We really have tons of examples where teams are waiting weeks to get access to copies. And the bad news is that it is a never-ending story. Because when you deliver your copies, in fact, you are not fully done, because the copies need to be refreshed all the time at every project iteration to provide a meaningful environment to the developers. I think you understood where I wanted to go. System copies are an automation challenge for most of the companies. And if you do not address the problem, at the end of the day, it has an impact on your innovation capabilities. Once again, the Atomic platform can be really useful. Atomic automates not only the copy steps, across the copy steps, but it automates all operations inside each of the steps. So globally, you have two benefits. You improve the overall copy process because you have a better coordination between steps, no manual handover between the teams, and you accelerate each of the steps by getting rid of the command line, integrating more easily with third-party technology, and also using parallel executions. So what are the two major capabilities of the system copy solution we have at CA Technology? First capability, self-service. The copy process is fully unattended and it is available on demand by the developers or the testers that require a copy. Also, demands for copies can be integrated directly into your help desk or your ITSM portal. Second capability, customized copies. Third-party integrations let you fully control the actual database copy, but also interact with data masking engines for delivering anonymized copies. Clearly, one of the big differentiators Atomic have against generic copy solutions is that capability of supporting complex landscapes and customized copy processes that include third-party technologies. So again, let's see a customer example. Riho is a German company producing polymer solutions like structures for double glass windows. They have more than 100 SAP systems, and like many other companies, they need to copy their production systems on a regular basis. When we first met the company, they were concerned about the time they needed to deliver the system copies. It was mainly because of manual post-processing, things like adjusting parameters, user rights, profiles, system settings, interfaces. And by automating their system copies, they could reduce the burden of the basis team from 35 man days to one single man day. This was really a good result, And the main output was a much better alignment between the SAP team and the development teams. So what are the main benefits you can expect from automating your SAP system copies? First, you reduce dramatically target system downtime. Most often, downtime reduction is very impressive. It is up to 90%. So system copies do not block your development teams anymore, or the testing teams anymore. And second benefit, you can boost the delivery of the copies. You can reduce the delivery time from days to just minutes. I mean, you can do more copies and you can align with the pace of agile development teams. All that with reducing the amount of manual operations and releasing the basis teams for working on more strategic projects, and for example, the postmodern ERP implementation. Okay, now let's address the last use case of this webinar. And this last use case is about SAP user or SAP customer experience. Of course, you know that customer experience is getting more and more critical with digital transformation. So proactive problem resolution is key to protect the experience you deliver, but it is not something easy to achieve. Many companies still struggle with early detection of issues and associated proactive remediation. So what influences customer experience? In the end, it still comes down to the mean time to repair, the MTTR. And the challenge is how quickly can your teams find and fix issues that make applications or services to slow down. Because at the moment the issues are perceived by the end users, the clock starts ticking, the user or the customer experience is going down. So to address this, you need a way to anticipate issues and to accelerate problem resolution. But proactive resolution is not so easy for many reasons. A recent Gartner study shows that 72% of companies are still using fragmented monitoring tools. And most often, those tools cannot tell the difference between a routine spike and a growing problem. So the teams are busy with false alarms and event storms that are impacting their reaction time. Another difficulty comes when actually fixing the problems. You need to coordinate multiple expertise, network, storage, application. So once again, you're never sure you get the right guy at the right place at the right time. Of course, automation and more specifically contextual automation can help you with this situation. Contextual automation means adding intelligence into the automated processes. For that, at CA Technology, we combine the capabilities of two platforms, the DX AIOps platform and the Atomic platform. The AIOps platform is built on top of an analytics engine. It can ingest data from not only the CA monitoring tools, but also any third-party tool on the market. And it applies machine learning and artificial intelligence to deliver contextual correlations. Then the AIOps platform feeds predictive insights into the Atomic platform. And Atomic drives the autonomous remediation by executing the workflows that will fix the issues. Automation makes possible to address the two major difficulties of proactive remediation. The first one is the early detection of service issues, even in complex or noisy environments. And the second one is the reliable execution of complex tasks across multiple technologies. So it really makes possible to automatically protect the user or the customer experience. Now I propose to better understand what is contextual automation with a simple example, a kind of hello world of the contextual automation. This is a use case where the AIOps platform will detect an SAP performance issue. Then it informs the Automic platform to validate the remediation scenario and to resolve automatically the problem. Okay, so we are in the demonstration now. We are running the CA APM tool and we are monitoring the SAP application. We can see that for the moment everything is fine, but it is just for the moment. We are now looking at the Automic platform. We can see a job queue that is controlling the SAP batch activity. And everything is normal also for the moment on the Automic platform. We have created a workflow in order to manage automatically potential incidents. So the workflow starts with creating a ticket in ServiceNow. Then it tries to scale down the batch activity and to intercept jobs to regulate the workload. It can intercept user jobs. Then the ticket is updated with the operations just done, and there is a check to validate the incident resolution. If the incident is resolved, then we just terminate the workflow. But if the incident is not resolved after 15 minutes, a new set of actions is executed. A new SAP application server is provisioned to scale up the capacity. And just after, the ticket is updated accordingly to set everything that was done with the new server. And incident resolution is checked again. If the incident is resolved, then the ticket is closed and the workflow will end. If not, the incident is forwarded to an escalation group. Okay, now we see that there is a performance problem. We can see the workflow has been started automatically. Batch activity has already been reduced, and the incident resolution is being checked. So we are going back into the Automic platform. We can see the SAP job queue has been reduced. Now only 10 jobs can run concurrently, and we can see that 40 jobs are now waiting to be executed. We can see here the new configuration for the job queue length. It has been set to 10 jobs to reduce the workload. Then we are back in the workflow, waiting incident resolution to be checked. And we can see that the problem was not fixed. So now it is necessary to execute operations in order to provision a new SAP server to increase the capacity. So it is, yes, it is done. So the ticket has been updated again, adding information about the new server. And another check is done for the incident resolution. And you can see this time the incident was fixed and the workflow is now terminated. The performance issue has been resolved in a totally unattended way. It has been automated end-to-end from detection in the APM tool up to the resolution by the automation tool. What benefits can you expect from contextual automation? We have a few figures from a study we made with the help of Forrester Consulting. As you can imagine, the main result is a dramatic improvement of the mean time to repair, and the explanation is really simple. In fact, you detect real issues earlier, you start remediation sooner, and you fix problems faster. So you win time on three important steps that let you improve the user experience. But this is not the only aspect you get improvements. Cost reduction, of course, is not the main driver for contextual automation, but you can also expect significant gains by reducing the volume of service desk tickets and limiting the number of manual interventions. We are now approaching the end of this webinar, and before closing the session, I'd like you to get a few takeaways about Automic solutions for SAP. We have seen three use cases today, but using the Automic platform, you can get benefits from many other use cases. So use cases like extending FCC processes outside the SAP world, automating business object reports, automating mass data processing for those of you using the SAP industry solutions. So in fact, one single automation platform can provide you with multiple opportunities for optimizing your SAP operations. I think I'm done. Hope you could get some interesting input from this webinar. Time for you, Tony, to close the session or maybe to get some questions.
Certainly, thank you very much, Jan. And yes, we do have some questions. If viewers, if you happen to have a question and it's a burning issue, please type it in now to the question section. Some of you have already done this. So the first question you have, Jan, is how can you get such a dramatic improvement with system copy runtimes?
In fact, it is important to understand that maybe the quick win is not the physical database copy. Where you can expect a lot of improvement is during the pre-copy process or the post-copy process. Just by automating a pre-copy, post-copy, you are reducing delays a lot. This explains the dramatic improvement you can get on the system copy. But of course, if your main problem is about the physical copy, the copy of the physical database, you can integrate our system copy solutions with multiple options. It can be database virtualization, it can be SAN snapshot. It can be a lot of options that will help you also to accelerate the actual copy of the database.
Cool, thank you very much. And your second question that's come in is, how much can I reduce costs using the Automic platform? That's quite a general question.
It depends. We have return on investment tools that can be used, and they provide figures that are adapted to every customer. But in fact, I would say this is not only about cost reduction. Automation is also about innovation and giving the means of developing new services, new customer experience faster. So, of course, automation for a long time, it has been about the bottom line, but you should not forget now it is also about the top line. So this is why it is complicated to give general figures. The best way is to do a study and to compute the ROI depending on the situation.
Thank you. Thank you very much for that. And we have one more question at the moment. Nobody else seems to be typing a question, but we have one more. You mentioned Automic platform that is suitable for multiple automation use cases. What do you mean exactly by that?
It is important to understand that all automation use cases that we can develop on top of the Atomic platforms, Atomic platform, they are using the same technology. You can in fact run just a single instance of the platform to deploy multiple use cases. So for example, with Atomic, you can do SAP automation, you can do Oracle automation, you can do continuous delivery, you can do server provisioning, but you don't need five tools. You just need one platform and one instance of that platform will be sufficient to host and to support all these use cases.
Oh, excellent. Thank you very much. We do seem to have reached the end of all of our questions now. So I would like to say thank you, Jan, for presenting Agile SAP Operations. I hope you, the audience, have all found it useful and are excited about the potential that's going on. I'd like to thank you all for attending and enjoy the rest of your day.